All right, we're with Susie Hosterman, who is one of the artists who will be featured in the February 28th, 2020 Erie Art Museum Gallery Night. Susie is a very eclectic artist. She does photography and painting, I think drawing. Susie, why don't you tell us a little bit about what folks coming to Gallery Night can expect with regard to what they'll see from your work, and then we'll talk more about, you know, your inspirations and what's next.
All right. Well, what they can expect is to see a few of my paintings, definitely the acrylic paintings that I do, which include abstract swirly art, which is a nice breath of fresh air, so your mind doesn't have to think too much. It can just enjoy the color. And then also on the flip side, I have more realistic images, portraits, what I like to call rocks and stone art that I've arranged and taken photographs of to explore different connections that people in the community can have. So three of the prints include, one is called Diversity, one is called Growth, and the other is called Support, which is my favorite because it has two rocks that are like looking like they're comforting each other.
It's interesting, the abstract photography that you do and the story that you're trying to tell with that abstract photography. Do you try to pull abstract themes through all of your work, or it just depends on your mood and what you're trying to say with each piece?
Yeah, I tend to start with a concept. If it's with the photography, I know the overall theme that I want to get across, and it usually has a lot to do with connection, because when we're looking at art, we're naturally connecting anyway, and I want to bring community together. Like, social themes are very important to me.
And with the painting that you're doing for this show, and maybe just in general, one, it's bigger than you've worked with, so maybe we'll talk about that. And then, you know, at least a piece in your studio today that you're working on definitely is people-centered, and, you know, it's abstract, but it's definitely got a reportage feel rather than an abstract feel. So just talk a little bit about, you know, where your themes are, how your themes are coming together for the painting that you're currently doing.
The large painting that I'm working on right now is one of the biggest ones I've ever worked on. I am painting it layer by layer. So in the beginning, I was not mixing colors at all. And I just wanted to see how that came about. So I started with the primary colors, just red, yellow, and blue. And at every stage, I would take a picture and I was like, how is this building? And now I'm starting to actually mix the colors, and it's starting to take more form, which is really exciting because, yeah, it's been a while.
You know, I think I mentioned I like the color palette. There's cooler colors. They match very well. I think in almost any, in art like this, the layers of color and just, it just gives it a really nice depth. And then, you know, big is, you know, it's about 3 feet by 4 feet. So is that overwhelming for you to say, I'm going to try a really big canvas for me, or is it exciting to just, you know, try something completely different?
I would say in the beginning it was very terrifying when I first bought the canvas and I was staring at it and I thought, what am I putting on you? But then as soon as I had the outline in there, like a really rough yellow sketch, I was like, okay, it's ready. It's time to get going with this. And I have enjoyed every time that I sit in front of it and work on it.
And the big piece that we have here depicts either family or friends in a comfortable family room or living room. The other painted pieces at the that will be on display for Gallery Night, are they along the same theme?
I have one other portrait that I'm showing, and then the other two paintings are more abstract swirl work. So this is, yeah, I would say the one portrait I'm showing is called Sarah, and it's of a friend of mine, and it comes across very Renaissance or Dutch, because she's looking over her shoulder, and it was the first time that I painted with a dry brush, that it was it was exciting to try that technique.
Now, the piece here in your studio today is acrylic, is and the portrait of Sarah, is that sort of what you're getting at the Dutch Masters sort of a feel? And was that, would that be oil or is that acrylic?
It is also acrylic,
okay,
yeah.
And also a bit abstract or more
yes.
realistic?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It definitely has a more expressionistic vibe going on.
And, you know, your training and background, you graduated in 2012 from Edinburgh University. You spent most of your studies there kind of photography related.
Kind of.
But then what happened?
Yeah, well, they talk about how I study graphic design, and graphic designers tend to either go the photography route or they go the illustration route. And because I knew I was great at photography, I loved it, I was winning awards for years, that was definitely what I showcased while I was there. But then the last class that I took at Edinburgh was a painting class. It was the last one. It was the only class I was taking too, so I could focus on it. And I realized that I maybe should have been doing more of this. And early on, I did have a drawing professor who told me, when he saw my skills, he's like, you know, you might want to think about minoring in painting. But I already had two minors at the time, and I was definitely overworked. So I think it worked out, though. I think it's nice to have this time to explore my own style before considering going back and getting my master's, because I definitely am doing that.
Great. And that was kind of my last question, is what's next? So could be a master's in art or master's in art education, or have you decided yet?
Oh, my gosh. Well, I grew up in a college, basically, because my dad was a music professor at Lock Haven University, and which is why I came up here, because it was a sister school, Edinburgh. And my mom also worked at the local university in music. And I just was always around that, and seeing how I would sit in on my dad's classes at a very young age, and seeing how passionate he was about teaching others, and knowing that I also had that flair for performance and educating, I consider that a lot right now. I would love to. It's trying to figure out what I want to focus in because of all my passions and all my interests.
But you're not going to stop doing art and photography, I hope.
Oh, no. I am doing it all. Yes.
Susie, thank you for giving us your time, and we look forward to seeing your work in the upcoming gallery night.
All right. Thank you.